Blake Jenner and Jane Levy here to talk about the new Netflix series, What If? So a little backstory here. We had Gabriel Mann earlier, like about 2 days ago here, talking about the series. And he must have sold somebody because all the ladies back in entertainment binge watched it and they're like, oh my God, it's incredible.
Great.
So you've got it already. Got fans already.
Yeah, nicely done.
So give a little story, give a little backstory for your characters in the show.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're following two cash-strapped newlyweds, which is Sean and Lisa. And they're trying to make ends meet. They've been at it for a while. Lisa's a scientist. She's like holding down her own company. And then by chance, they meet this powerful financier
woman. Mm-hmm.
Yes, by chance. Uh-huh. You got to check it out and see what that chance means. But she offers to fund my wife's company for $80 million in exchange for one night with me.
Oh, wow. That's
pretty wild.
That's an ego boost.
We got a little indecent proposal twist, huh? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And this financier you're talking about, Renée Zellweger.
Yes, yes. Wow.
So what was it like working with her?
It was a dream. I mean, she's an incredible actress and an incredible person. In this series, she plays, you know, like our villain. She plays evil, nihilistic, witch.
Okay.
But in real life,
she's a great person. In real life.
No, but in real life, she's really such a kind, generous, warm person. So it was fun to watch her step into Anne Montgomery's shoes. Mm-hmm.
Okay. I believe we have a clip of all three of you together. Do you know what scene we're about to show?
I think so.
Yeah.
Okay, go for it.
This is where things get heavy.
Let's take cheating out of the equation. Say you were fully complicit in our affair. Would that be an acceptable condition of a firm offer to finance your company?
You're asking if I would be willing to trade my husband for my company? No, that would not be an acceptable condition. Anne, let's get out of here.
Lisa, wait, it's just a game. Like Lionel and his bowl of questions.
Only not nearly as original.
Blake's character doesn't feel so strongly. He's like, let's discuss.
Yeah, like it's $80 million.
Come on.
Yeah.
I'll take one for the team.
Come on, baby, let's do this. We can do this.
Wow, that's so we were talking earlier about the series Revenge, but same creators, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mike Kelly, Melissa Loy.
Well, so you're also in good hands?
Totally.
Oh, absolutely. They've become like close friends of ours now. It's like going to work, working with your friends, having laughs, like joking around the entire time. So we felt very much at home.
And another thing we were discussing with Gabriel was when you're a part of a Netflix series, the promotion that they have is just unparalleled to anything else. I mean, are you guys seeing the same things? Billboards everywhere and...
Yeah, there's like four or five billboards around the city. That's like the first time that's ever happened
with
me.
Cool.
So like I sent,
yes, we did it.
We made it.
We made it.
No, I've sent like pictures to my mom and my dad. I was like, check this out.
Yeah.
My mom's like, oh honey, that's just incredible.
Where do they live?
They live in Miami. That's where,
okay.
That's where I grew up. Yeah.
Wow.
Now, are they seeing any over there?
They are. Yeah. My entire family.
That's awesome. What about you?
I saw myself on a billboard, took a picture underneath it. I mean, it's great when you turn on Netflix right now, our show pops up and I'm glad they're pushing it and I'm glad people are watching it and responding to it.
Wow, that's awesome. All right, well, you could catch it streaming on Netflix now.
Right now.
Right now. Yes.
What If.
What If.
Netflix, check it out.
Blake and Jane,
thank you
guys.
So much.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you so much.
You too.